Hey, how's it going, everybody? If you're new here, welcome in. And if you've been here before, welcome back. I'm Rollshambo, the connoisseur and collector of all things sharp and shiny. And today I want to talk about the Kizer Dogfish. This is a knife that I've already unboxed. And if you want to see that video, if you want to see my first impressions and initial reaction to this knife, we'll go ahead and pop it up in the corner. With that being said, I do find it necessary to revisit knives after I've had my first initial impression, because you know what? Knives often are so exciting to get. You know, you pull them out of the packaging and they're shiny and they're new, and often they have at least some kind of edge on them, and you're excited. You're excited because it's not something you've experienced before. And if you're a fan of knives, if you're an enthusiast, a collector, a user, if you just like experiencing, you know, different designs and different pieces, it's really easy to get lost in the sauce when it comes to knives, because a week later you might not feel the same. A month later you might not feel the same. For some people, the honeymoon period, as I like to call it, lasts a few hours. For some, a few weeks. But that is, in fact, why I think it's important to revisit these things, to revisit these knives. And so I'm not going to call this a review, just more so my thoughts on the overall design after I've had a chance to live with this knife, to use it, to carry it, and to experience it well beyond the honeymoon phase. Because after that point, things might start to become apparent that you might not have really noticed before, both good and bad. Now, with all of that, I have to mention, this knife is impressive. The price tag, $99. And, you know, for $99, you get, honestly, the best aluminum that I've tried on a sub-$100 knife this year. Yeah, I'll say that again. The Kizer Dogfish has the best aluminum handle scales from the factory that I've experienced on a knife so far that's under $100. Yeah, round of applause. And if you don't like my sound effects, I don't really care, because that's just how I operate. I like sound effects. The radial milling on here is fantastic. When you consider the cost of doing something like radial milling on aluminum, I don't think people do really consider the cost. You know, this extra machine work does count for something, and I like it because it adds some really good texture to the handle scales, and it also adds some character to the knife. And it's really easy to get lost in that radial milling, because it took me a minute to remember there's no body screws on this knife. You see that? There's no body screws. We have one pocket clip screw. We have the pivot screws. That's it. There's no outward facing body screws. That's fantastic. It's a really, really sleek design. And I think that more knives should be built this way. You know, why have extra hardware when it's not needed? We all said, oh, we're tired of seeing T6 body screws. And Kizer said, well, if you're just going to complain about it, we'll take all the screws away. And I really, really think that that was a great idea. It is a button lock, and this button lock sticks out quite a lot. So something that I heard people mention in the comments section of my initial video was, well, if you're bearing down on it, are you going to disengage that lock? No, this is me bearing down on it. I'm covering that track lock. No, not at all. Have I experienced any issues with this knife in that time? No. In fact, I haven't experienced any issues. Over time, I expected me to have more negative things to say about it, because if you give me long enough with just about anything, I can usually find something to complain about. And this one's no different. One of my complaints is that I can't believe that we don't have a single-sided captive pivot. There's no reason why we shouldn't. In fact, I think that they could have done a really neat motif on a single-sided captive pivot, you know, really finish out that radial milling, and I think that would have been sweet. But they didn't do that, and it's not a huge deal. It's just a design thing that I can't help but think that they missed out on adding in just a little bit of extra flair on a knife that quite honestly doesn't need it. Also, we have this pocket clip insert right here because you can, in fact, take this 3D mil pocket clip and flip it to the other side. That's neat. I really enjoy that. I really enjoy the fact that lefties, as a wholly underrepresented group, can actually have this on the other side. Can you switch the button? No, but I think that pretty much anybody could learn to live with that. This knife is extremely fidgety, and it is one of those options that I think a lot of people who like to have like 10 deployment options on a knife, if that's you, you're going to enjoy this. You can thumb flick it, you can reverse flick it, you can do the rear flipper, you can do the front flipper. Wait, okay. I'm not good with front flippers. There we go. So, you know, whatever your flavor is, it's got you covered, and it's a very, very fidgety knife. The action is really good. It is a guillotine when you press and hold the button. Now, button locks are not my favorite for anything more than, you know, chopping up boxes, opening packages, you know, maybe cutting into some fruit on the road. But anything after that, I'm not a huge fan of button locks. I think that they're very good at keeping your fingers out of the path of travel. And that's important to remember, is that a lot of people don't need some serious knife lock strength. We want enough to be comfortable and we want enough to be safe. But other than that, I would say for most average everyday people who aren't using this knife for work, a button lock is going to be more than adequate. Now, I still don't know if this pocket clip is actually titanium or if it's like aluminum. I know that it's non-magnetic and I know that it's 3D milled. I haven't been able to find any information on what that pocket clip is made out of. Now, I know that the comment section usually has my back on these things. So if you happen to know if this pocket clip is in fact titanium or aluminum or whatever, please, please let me know. I'm over here just fidgeting with this knife, but I can't help it. The knife is extremely fidgety and it's very easy to index, and it makes it very, very nice to carry. It's one of those pieces that's going to be, you know, a full-size knife, but it's also not too big to be egregious. My favorite grip on a knife is being able to pinch up here at the top with my thumb and my index finger parallel like this, because that's just where I find the most control. And I also like being able to do pinch grips like that as well, because it allows me to get the cut that I want. It allows me to feel secure in what I'm using the knife for. And then the button lock makes it easy to deploy and to put away one-handed, no problem. Fingers are never in the cutting path. It's quite frankly a very impressive knife. And you know what? Do I have regrets? Because remember, I named this, the Civivi Sentinel Strike, as the button lock of the year in 2023. And then shortly after, Kizer sent me this one. And you know what? I'm not taking the award back, because I think that the Civivi Sentinel Strike is fantastic. I love this knife. I mean, obviously I do. One of the complaints people had on this one is the FRN backspacer and the fact that it does feel a tad bit slippery in the hands. That's not an issue with the Kizer Dogfish at all. You get plenty of grip on here, and you get full aluminum handle scales versus aluminum and FRN. I think the FRN on the Sentinel Strike, by the way, was a mistake. I think they should have kept it aluminum as well, or at least grippy G10. Grippy G10 on that would have been fantastic. But I digress. The Kizer Dogfish, this could have been the knife that knocked off the Civivi Sentinel Strike as far as button lock of the year in 2023. I'm not going to do that, because at the time of filming, this was the best button lock that I had experienced last year. And I don't think that that takes away from how good this knife truly is. I don't think that $99 is too expensive for this. For what you get, the amount of attention to detail in the design, aside from the pivot, the other thing that I do find myself wishing is that this backspacer was a little bit longer. I mean, yes, it would add weight, but it's not terribly heavy as is. You have the pocketed milling on the inside liners, and you also have aluminum scales, which are not heavy to begin with. So I don't understand why we couldn't have protected that blade a little bit more in the closed position. That would have been something that I personally would have preferred. Ultimately, I think that This is a fantastic piece that a lot of people are going to be happy with. They're already sold out on Kizer's website. But if you want to pick one up, feel free to use my link in the description down below. I will link it in the description. And if you do use it, full disclosure, that is an affiliate link. You will, in fact, be helping the channel when you use it or don't. We just got done with the holiday. A lot of people have spent a ton of money. But if you're looking for a truly fantastic fidgety button lock knife that's going to excel in your basic EDC tasks, I think you could do a hell of a lot worse than the Kizer Dogfish. But let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section down below. Have you picked one of these up yet? Are you planning on picking up one of these? If not, why not? Let's have a discussion. And if you want to watch more awesome knife and EDC content, go ahead and click on one of the videos that pops up next.